be the first of the four features, and here's your starting lineup. It'll be Morristown, Tennessee's Chris Rickett in the 36. He'll start on the pole alongside the 14 of Newport, Tennessee's Kurt Owens. Row 2 to the inside, Parrotsville, Tennessee's Wayne Reeder in 01 and the M2. Out of Morristown, Tennessee, it'll be Shannon Emery. Row 3 to the inside, the 14 car to Morristown, Tennessee is Austin Atkins. And the 69 car of Nick Presley. Row 4 to the inside, Michael Woods out of White Pine, Tennessee, and Jonesboro, Tennessee's Jeff Ferguson in 24. Row 5, it'll be Charlie Bates in 27 and R.J. Mays in the 6 car. Row 6, it'll be Brett Banks in 3, Caleb Trent in 3T. Row 4, the Wizard of Oz, John Cook in the 0Z outside the 11 of Tracy Wolf. And row 8, it will be Terry Dean in the 47 and the 31 of Parker Estes. Looks the field over as they head down the back straightaway. It is Chris Rickett and Kurt Owens. Ready to go, green flag racing to kick off the 13th annual Scorcher. Out of turn number 4, they'll bring them to the start line, ladies and gentlemen. It is showtime at the gap. They race into turn number 1 and head down the back straightaway. Kurt Owens off the top side. Rickett moves up the hill. They're going to get together down the back straightaway. Contact with your leaders and the caution is out. Hard into the wall down the back straightaway goes Jeff Ferguson and the caution is out. Chris Rickett and Kurt Owens to the start line. We'll try it again. Good start. Here we go. Rickett doesn't get a good start at all. They stack up going into turn number 1. And not going to stick. Not going to stick. We're going to do it a third time. Trying again, hoping the third time will be the charm. As Chris Rickett and Kurt Owens will bring them out of turn number 4, they'll fire. We're back underway. Good start by that time. We'll see if we get a lap in. They go 3 wide down the back straightaway out of turn number 2. Kurt Owens will grab the lead. Rickett will slide up the hill into second. Emery is third. Fourth will be Wayne Rader. Here comes Austin Atkins. They're going to go 3 wide for third down the front straightaway. Car with a problem down the front straightaway. I believe it's R.J. Mays. It's the 3 car of Caleb Trent. And we'll see if he's going to be able to get off the racetrack. As they race down the front straightaway to complete lap number 2, Kurt Owens with the lead. Rickett all over him for the lead down the back straightaway. Austin Atkins has made it to third. Now they're side by side for the fifth spot. Here comes Michael Woods to the inside of Wayne Rader. Side by side for the fifth spot as they race down the front straightaway. Now Rickett looks to the inside of Kurt Owens. They'll battle for the lead down the back straightaway. Everybody running the top side of the speedway. Kurt Owens trying to hold off Chris Rickett as they come out of turn number 4. And with 4 laps in the books, now 16 to go. Kurt Owens pulls away just a little bit from Rickett, but Rickett's going to run him back down through the center of the corner. Lap traffic going to be an issue here in about 2 or 3 laps as we complete 5. 15 to go for your leaders as they head down the back straightaway. Got a smoker running 7th place as Nick Presley. We'll see if that metastasizes into anything deeper. As they race down the front straightaway, John Cook and Terry Ding will be the first 2 cars to go a lap down. And now the 69 car starting to smoke a little bit heavier. So possible problems on the 69 car. Parker Estes gets sideways out of turn number 4. And the leaders are in lap traffic. Kurt Owens with 2 lap cars side by side in front of him. He thinks about splitting them down the back straightaway and does. Rickett's going to follow him through the hole. They both get through. Now to the inside of Kurt Owens, side by side for the lead, down the front straightaway. Here comes Chris Rickett. Austin Atkins sticks his nose through lap traffic, down the back straightaway. We're still side by side for the lead. Rickett to the inside of Kurt Owens, tries the slider in turn number 3, can't pull it off. It's still Kurt Owens, your leader, 1 lap shy of halfway. Austin Atkins trying to run down the top 2 as now Michael Woods and Shannon Emery will battle side by side for 4th through lap traffic with John Cook, and Michael Woods is going to use the 0 as a pick in turn number 3. Now it could get interesting if we stay green as Tracy Wolf and Brett Banks have been side by side for position for several laps, and that is the next 2 cars to go a lap down, so we'll see what Kurt Owens and the 36 of Chris Rickett can do. as they head down the back straightaway. Kurt Owens seems to have a little bit of a handling issue in the center of the corners. Here comes Rickett. They're going to get together. Side by side for the lead down the front straightaway. They battle back into turn number one. Rickett slides up the hill out of turn number two. Here comes Owens back to the outside. Still side by side for the lead. Rickett's going to pile it down in turn number three. What a move. Here comes Kurt Owens for the lead. New leader is Chris Rickett. 13 in the book, 7 to go. And the 36 car has taken the lead. Chris Rickett out front showing the way. Kurt Owens running second. Austin Atkins trying to get through lap cars to stay in touch with the top two. Kurt Owens seems to have a little bit of a handling issue. Very tight on entry as he gets into turn one and turn three. Tracy Wolf will pull to the infield and call it quits in 11. Out of turn number four, problems in turn one. Big smoker is Nick Presley. Looks like the 69 car has let go. RJ Mays is slow down the back straightaway. Hang on, leaders. And RJ Mays is going to have to draw the yellow up in turn number three. It's slow in a racetrack. Caution is out. And the caution is out. Nick Presley goes up in smoke, but RJ Mays slows at the top. Single file restart as we'll bring them back to green. Out of turn number four, it is Chris Rickett out front leading Kurt Owens, Austin Atkins, as they fire out of turn number four. 5 laps to go. They race back into one and head down the back straightaway. Woods looks to the inside of Austin Atkins, can't get anything off the bottom. Now Kurt Owens trying to mount a run on your leader, Chris Rickett, down in turn number three. 4 to go. Here comes Michael Woods. He'll look back to the inside of Austin Atkins in turn number one and two again. Good run for the White Pine Tennessee driver. Been really coming on strong later here in the season, having some solid top three runs. As the top two start to break away from the rest of the field as they head down the back straightaway. Kurt Owens trying to run down Chris Rickett and take a shot back for the lead as they come out of turn number four, 2 laps to go. Chris Rickett had a great turn one that time, and he pulls a lot of distance on Kurt Owens down the back straightaway. That could do it as the white flag will come out final time around. Good race still for third between the 66 of Woods, Austin Atkins. They're side by side. Shannon Emery is there with Wayne Rader. Final time down the back straightaway. Into three and out of four. Worked his way around in lap traffic. Chris Rickett's going to victory lane. We got problems in turn four. Austin Atkins sideways. Second goes to Owens, third to Michael Woods. Fourth will go to Shannon Emery, and fifth to Austin Atkins. So problems on the last lap as Austin Atkins gets sideways. He's having a discussion with Michael Woods. Austin Atkins will bring it home fifth. Emery's going to get fourth. Good run, podium finish for the 66 of Michael Woods in third. Kurt Owens holds on to the runner-up spot. But your winner, out of Morristown, Tennessee, in the Rickett Sheet Metal Blistered Chicken Saloon, Edward Forrest Products, DJ's Performance Powered Camaro. How about it for the 36 of Chris Rickett? Of the Boyd Speedway out of Chattanooga, Tennessee, it'll be David Duplessis. Row number 10 to the inside, it'll be Sevierville, Tennessee's James Cole and the 52 car. Morristown Marine entry for Knoxville, Tennessee's Brad Hall. Row 11 to the inside, it's scheduled to be the 29 of Christian Hanger. Out of Winchester, Tennessee, with Preston Whitehead, Jerry Green, Jason Milton. Full field of crates for 15 laps. They'll fire out of four. We're underway. Whoa, there's big contact down into turn number one between Kyle Courtney and hard hit. Hard crash down in turn number one. The red is out. So the red will come out. Big pile up down in turn number one and two.
Yes, sir.
Man, be safe headed home, brother.
All right.
See you. Have a good show. So here we go, bringing them back to green. Good start by that time. And here comes Ross White to the outside of Corey Hedgecock. That battle side-by-side down the back straightaway as they get into turn number three. Side-by-side out of four. Ross White to the lead. Zero out in front. Corey Hedgecock runs second. Jordan Horton pushes up the hill in turn number three. There goes Gary Crittenden. Rusty Ballinger down to the inside for four. Jason Trammell looking and flirting with the top five as Whitehead pulls to the infield. Hang on, Tim Maupin out of turn number four. We got problems down the front straightaway. Caution is out. Tim Maupin got sideways in the middle of the field out of four and collected Taryn Hurst. There was contact with another car, and I believe it was John Llewellyn. So here we go. We'll bring them back to green. Out of turn four. Big stack up getting into turn number three. They fire, and we're back underway. Cars sideways all through the center of turn number four as they head down the front straightaway. As they race down the back straightaway, look at Kyle Courtney rocketing around the outside through the back and the center of the field, trying to make his way back to the front with just three in the books. Long way to go. Chris Chandler looks to the outside of Jordan Horton. He'll go into the top five. Tim Bird looking to challenge as well. Jordan Horton with a lot of damage on the 56, and it is certainly affecting the performance of the 56 cars. He has fallen outside of the top five. Ross White trying to pull away from Corey Hedgecock as they get into turn number three. Third runs Gary Crittenden. Rusty Ballinger's made it up to fourth, looking to challenge for the third spot. Fifth runs Chris Chandler, then it's Horton. Seventh is Tim Bird. Good battle for eighth between Jason Trammell and the 15 of Bryson Dennis, and John Llewellyn rounds out the top 10. Here comes the battle for third out of turn number two. Rusty Ballinger looks inside the 18 of Crittenden as they race down the back straightaway. Dives it down into turn number three. They're side by side for third, racing down the front. Ross White out front continuing the lead. Corey Hedgecock running in second. Ross White starting to close in on the tail of the field. Yes, Brad Hall and Taryn Hurst battle at the tail end of the field. So lap cars coming for your leader, Ross White, as we approach 10 laps to log into the books. It will be 20 to go. This time by problems out of four, it's Jason Milton. And the caution is back out. Jason Milton around on his own. For the restart, Ross White fires out of turn number four. We're back underway. Back into turn number one. Corey Hedgecock looks for the lead down the back straightaway, slides up the hill and can't get there. Now Rusty Ballinger to third. Look at Rusty Ballinger around the outside of the 18 of Gary Crittenden. They're nearly four wide out of turn number four. Racing in the middle of the pack for sixth, seventh, and eighth. Down the back straightaway, Jason Trammell making a move. He's up to sixth from ninth. Using the outside part of the racetrack, Jordan Horton will be next on the hit list. They're four wide in the back of the pack. Contact with Kyle Courtney and Chris Chandler. They keep going. As they race down the back straightaway, Kyle Courtney is sideways, and Dave Duplessis hard into the wall. Goes Kyle Courtney down the back straightaway. And the caution will come out. And Logan Robertson has made it from 10th to 7th on that restart. So a couple of movers as we'll bring them back to green. Ross White brings them down slow. They fire back underway. They're three wide for fifth as they head into turn number one. Here comes Jason Trammell. Look at Mighty Mouse around the outside in 97 as they head down the back straightaway. He and Robertson both sidestep Jordan Horton as they get down into turn number three. They race down the front straightaway. They complete 13 laps. Corey Hedgecock headed down the back straightaway trying to get a look in the zero. Ross White couldn't get there. And Jason Trammell still side by side with Logan Robertson. Waynesboro, Virginia's Logan Robertson trying to make his way to the front. He and Jason Trammell side by side for fifth back into turn number one. Gary Crittenden runs fourth right in front of him. And Jordan Horton right behind the duo in seventh. Jason Trammell about to the outside now, trying to keep the momentum up around the 4/10 mile Volunteer Speedway. Logan Robertson likes the low road here at the gap tonight in both ends of the racetrack, turn number one and three. As he runs the bottom in both ends, Jason Trammell still on the outside, best battle on the racetrack right now for that fifth spot. Jordan Horton running seventh, eighth is Tim Bird, ninth is Chris Chandler, who is side by side with the 15 of Bryson Dennis. Christian Hanger there in the 29 as well, all flirting with the top 10. Ross White's been trying to pull away from Corey Hedgecock. Rusty Ballinger hanging tough as well. All of them running just about identical lap times as they come out of turn number four. Jason Trammell's made it up to fifth in the 97 car. Continues to run the outside part of the racetrack, and he is running down Gary Crittenden in a hurry. Logan Robertson sticks true to the bottom. Now battle for seventh. Here comes Tim Burton. He'll look to Horton as they get into turn number three. Ross White starting to catch a couple of slower cars that get into turn number three. Jason Melton and Taryn Hurst. As they hit back into turn number one, less than 10 to go, 21 in the books, 9 laps to go. Corey Hedgecock, fastest in hot laps, fastest in qualifying, started on the pole. Ross White used the outside pole to his advantage, got the lead. Hasn't looked back. Corey Hedgecock trying to get back to battle for the lead, but he missteps up in turn number two. Lost a little bit of momentum, and here comes Rusty Ballinger for second. Inside of Corey Hedgecock, you've got a new second place car. It's Rusty Ballinger. Corey Hedgecock, not a good lap at all for the Loudoun Lightning as he slips up in both corners. That last time, he'll fall to third, holding the podium spot. As Rusty Ballinger has made it to second, and he is trying to run down Ross White, your leader. Hard into the wall goes Gary Crittenden in turn number one and two. Fourth place car up into the wall, couldn't get out of it. Jason Trammell goes to fourth. Robertson's going to go for fifth down in turn number three. Slide job out of four. Tight racing down the front straightaway. Gary Crittenden may have problems on the 18 after getting into the wall. Meanwhile, Rusty Ballinger still trying to Ross White, Corey Hedgecock third. Good battle for fourth down between Robertson and Jason Trammell. They just can't get away from each other as they battle for fourth down the back straightaway. Jason Melton, the lap car. Ross White will get around him down the front straightaway. As we are less than 5 laps to go, Rusty Ballinger trying to run down Ross White for the lead. That zero has been oh so good all year long here in Crate Late Model action. Got a couple of $1,500 wins to his credit at big shows here at the Gap. Something about these special events just attract Ross White, but this one is not over as Rusty Ballinger's making his move towards the front. 2 laps to go, final 2 circuits. The leaders are right with lap traffic down the back straightaway. This one could get good as we'll come to the white flag out of turn number 4. White flag is in the air, final time around for Ross White. Can he hold on? John Llewellyn right in front of your leader. Ross White as they head down the back straightaway. Rusty Ballinger about 2 car lengths back. He's going to stab at it. Down in turn number 3. Looks for it. Slides up the hill. Can't get it done. Knoxville, Tennessee's Ross White's your winner. Second will go to Ballinger. Third to Hedgecock. Fourth will go to Jason Trammell. And Logan Robertson rounds out the top 5. The rest of the field comes to get the checker. Race fans, he's done it again. How about it for Knoxville, Tennessee's Ross White? Rusty Ballinger with a great run, surged through the field. He'll come home in second tonight. Third goes to Corey Hedgecock. Fourth to Jason Trammell in 97, and Waynesboro, Virginia's Logan Robertson will wrap out the top 5 here tonight to wrap up the 13th annual Scorcher Race. Fans, we appreciate you coming out and being with us here tonight. Don't forget, this Saturday night, 411 Motor Speedway, we wrap up a Walker's Collision Repair back to school night, and next Saturday night, August the 26th, we'll be back here at the Gap with Fan Appreciation Night, $5 grandstand admission. Please be careful headed home, and we'll see you down the road at the races.